Hello everyone, and welcome back at today's analysis. Now for the 28th episode, I'm going to analyze Luke Skywalker, one of the main protagonists of the Star Wars franchise. One of the most iconic heroes in cinematic history, and the ultimate representative of hope, Luke Skywalker is by far the greatest cinematic hero to ever appear, as coupled the fact that his name became synonymous with hope into a hopeless galaxy, and his journey from a simple boy in the desert to a legendary Jedi is absolutely inspiring. And in this episode I'm going to analyze all the information given about him from all the films and the TV shows of the franchise, to better understand Luke Skywalker in his journey from a simple orphan in the desert to the legendary Jedi who saved the entire galaxy. Now, without further ado, let's begin. Luke Skywalker was born in 19BBI on the asteroid of Polis Massa to his mother, Padme Amidala. Tragically, his mother has died giving birth to him, and Luke was taken care of on Tatooine by his uncle and aunt, Owen and Beru Lars. Growing up, Luke wanted to leave the planet in order to become a star pilot, like he believed his father was, as he was lied by his uncle and aunt that he was some sort of a pilot for the Suntray and Spicy Runners. However, by 0BBI, his entire life changed forever, as the two droids, C-3PO and R2-D2, came into his life after he and his uncle Bowden, who were working for the Rebel Alliance in their galactic civil war against the Galactic Empire. And these droids ultimately led Luke to meet Ben Kenobi, formerly known as Obi-Wan Kenobi, a former Jedi Master, and the one who secretly supervised Luke throughout his entire life. Ultimately here, he learned that his father, Anakin Skywalker, used to be a Jedi, before he was ultimately killed by Darth Vader, and when the Jedi were hunted down by the Empire. Ben offered Luke the possibility for him to train to become a Jedi. Although initially Luke refused, after he saw his aunt and uncle being executed by the Empire, ultimately resulted in Luke accepting his offer and joining the Rebel Alliance and become the Padawan of Obi-Wan Kenobi. And as they raced towards the planet of Alderaan, they ultimately discovered he was destroyed by the Death Star, a powerful planetary super weapon that is capable to destroy an entire planet. As they managed to board across aboard the Death Star with the help of Han Solo and his friend Chewbacca in order to save Princess Leia from the Empire. But tragically, Obi-Wan Kenobi has perished into a duel with Darth Vader, as he sacrificed himself so Luke and his friends can escape with Leia and the plans for the Death Star to the Rebel Alliance headquarters on Yavin 4. But nevertheless, Luke along with his friends managed to destroy the Death Star and save the Rebel Alliance. By this, he managed to destabilize the Empire and prove to the people that freedom from the Empire is actually possible. Thus, the Rebel Alliance gained an immense victory in its civil war against the Empire. But afterwards, by 0ABI, the Empire raided Yavin 4, and Luke and his troops managed to evacuate to a new planet, Hoth, where they established a new rebel base. However, by 3ABI, as the Empire invaded and conquered the planet Hoth, the rebels evacuated to a new rebel base, while Luke went to Dagobah to find the lost Jedi Master, Yoda, in order to finish his Jedi training. While on Dagobah, he was confronted with his worst fears. Ultimately, Luke managed to prevail in his training, only to be bothered by a vision of his friends being in danger, and thus he raced to the Cloud City on Bespin in order to save them, despite the fact that Yoda wanted the otherwise. Nevertheless, while on Bespin, Luke engaged with Darth Vader into a lightsaber duel in order to defeat him and avenge Obi-Wan Kenobi's death, and as well as his father's. But not only did Luke fail in the duel, but here, Luke Skywalker had the shock of his life that Darth Vader, his own arch nemesis, is actually his father, Anakin Skywalker. He tried to persuade him to join the dark side, so they both together can overthrow Darth Sidious, the Emperor of the Galaxy, and rule the Empire together, only for Luke to refuse and from the Cloud City, only to be saved by his friends. As later on, while his friend Han Solo was captured by Boba Fett and taken to Jabba the Hutt on Tatooine, Luke managed to acquire a new cybernetic hand and build himself a new lightsaber, and questioned himself why did Obi-Wan Kenobi lie to him about his father. But nevertheless, by 4ABI, Luke and his friends managed to save Han Solo from the clutches of Jabba, and managed to return back to the Rebel Alliance with him, who prepared for one final battle against the Empire, against the second Death Star built above Endor. But before he could do so, Luke arrived on Dagobah only to greet a dying Yoda, who confirmed to him that Darth Vader is actually his father. And later the ghost of Obi-Wan Kenobi confirmed the same thing and explained to him how Anakin turned to the dark side of the Force and became Darth Vader, as well as the fact that Leia, the princess of Alderaan, is actually his twin sister, Leia Skywalker. As Luke was forced with the decision to engage with his father and even to kill him, Luke refused to do so, as he couldn't kill his own father, But instead, his pursuit to redeem him and to save him from the dark side. And as he and his friends arrived on Endor in order to disable the deflector shield, in order to make the new Death Star vulnerable, Luke let himself capture by Vader and the Imperial forces, in order to be taken aboard the space station, where he finally met Darth Sidious for the very first time. As he and his father engaged to a duel, Sidious pursued Luke to kill him and take his place as his new Sith apprentice, only for him to refuse, as he claimed that he is a Jedi like his father before him. Disappointed, Sidious tried to kill Luke with his Force lightning. Only Darth Vader couldn't endure to see his own son suffering and die right in front of him. So he managed to redeem himself and throw Sidious on board into the second Death Star's core reactor, finally killing the Sith Emperor, at least for a time, and managed to redeem himself in the process. And thus Luke succeeded in defeating the Sith and to save his father. As he managed to escape with his father's corpse, the second Death Star exploded, and the Rebel Alliance managed to win the battle. And with this, the Galactic Empire began to collapse across the galaxy. And as Luke Skywalker held a funeral in his father's honor, he and his friends all went to their own ways. As Luke continued his journey to restore the Jedi Order, the Rebel Alliance reorganized itself into the New Republic. Both his Leia and Han married with each other. And by 5 ABI, the Galactic Civil War officially ended, with the Empire collapsed, the New Republic victorious, and the Imperial remnants escaping to the unknown regions. Eventually, Luke managed to restore the Jedi Order in 15 ABI, when he created a Jedi Temple on Ossus and began to train a new generation of Jedi, among them being his nephew, Ben Solo, the son of Leia Skywalker and Han Solo, who wanted to become a Jedi like his uncle and his grandfather before him. However, meantime, Luke felt the dark side is rising again from the unknown regions, specifically to the long-lost Sith world of Exegol, and both he and his friend Lando Calrissian started their own journey to find Exegol in order to end the conflict once and for all, only for failing to do so in 21 ABI as he abandoned the journey. And tragically, by 28 ABI, everything fell apart, first with the revelation that both he and Leia are the children of Darth Vader, which ruined Leia's political career and resulted in her resigning as senator and into the New Republic, and became general and created the resistance to combat the First Order, a new imperialist military junta that sought to restore the Empire. Another factor here is the fact that this shattered Ben's trust in his own family, as due to the manipulations of both Palpatine and Snoke, and ultimately Ben feeling closer and closer to the dark side of the Force, Luke, to do his fear, tried to strike down his own nephew, who horribly failed him, as Ben finally turned on him and collapsed the hut that he slept on over him, and destroyed the Jedi Temple, and killed the new generation of Jedi, finally causing a second extinction of the Jedi. Luke, feeling immense remorse for failing to restore the Jedi Order, and for feeling responsible for his nephew's fall to the dark side, ultimately exiled himself to Ashtu, where he wanted to die there as the last Jedi. Meanwhile, Ben joined the First Order as Kylo Ren, the master of the Knights of Ren, and the apprentice of Supreme Leader Snoke, as he and the First Order committed countless atrocities throughout the galaxy, as they and the New Republic engaged into some sort of a Cold War, in from 29 ABI all the way to 34 ABI. And as which culminated with the destruction of the Hostian system, the fall of the New Republic, and the beginning of a new galactic war between the Resistance and the First Order. However, by 34 ABI, as the war began, his life changed forever when a scavenger from Jakku, Rey, officially came to the planet to ask for his help, and recognizing that she is force sensitive, and she has the Skywalker lightsaber with her, ultimately Luke decided to train Rey as a Jedi, in order to help the Resistance. Eventually, he told Rey about everything that happened between him and Ben, and although originally he lied, he finally admitted that he did lead to Ben to fall to the dark side, due to his own fear. Rey became determined to save Ben from the darkness, and officially went and surrendered herself to the First Order, hoping that she could be able to defeat Snoke and redeem Kylo Ren, culminating in Ren killing Snoke, and usurping him as the new Supreme Leader of the First Order, and escalating the war with the Resistance. Thankfully, as the Resistance was on the deathbed and to be destroyed by the First Order on Crait, Luke managed to arrive to save the day. But now, before I go any further, we all should stop and ask ourselves, is Luke Skywalker good? Now, the reason why I'm asking this is simply because of the fact that while in the original trilogy, Luke was definitely good from all points of view, in the sequels, it seems that things might have changed a bit, in the sense that he became quite depressed, nihilist, and even isolated, to the point that he's willing to die as the last Jedi. As in his own words, it's time for the Jedi to end. However, Luke is nowhere to be an evil person. He is just depressed and disappointed that he failed to prevent the rise of another Darth Vader. And given the fact that he managed to change his ways after Rey showed him what is possible, and after Rey confronted him about what he has done to cause Ben to fall to the darkness to begin with, ultimately Luke managed to change his own mind and help the Resistance in order to save it from the First Order by sacrificing himself. Thus, ultimately, it can be discussed here that Luke is definitely a good person. And at the end of the day, the answer is yes. Luke Skywalker is a hero. He is a good person. And he cares about everyone, even after he basically lost almost everything. And at the end of the day, he sacrificed himself to save the Resistance from the First Order. As Sion Crate was nothing more but an astral projection, who managed to confront Kylo Ren and apologize to him after everything happened, and thus buying time for the Resistance led by his sister to escape, and Rey becoming the last Jedi. And to do this, Luke died of exhaustion on Naboo at the age of 53, but nevertheless, he left behind an impressive legacy. As his name became synonymous with hope in the galaxy, Rey became the last Jedi. And Leia continued to lead the Resistance in their fight against the First Order. But even that wasn't the end for Luke Skywalker, as 1 year later in 35 ABI, he came from beyond the grave to help Rey to defeat Darth Sidious once and for all, as well as helping her to redeem Ben Solo and finally defeat the First Order. So in the end, who was Luke Skywalker? A simple boy that would grow up into a famous Jedi and would take arms against the Empire. A famous boy that would become a man and who would do everything to protect and save his family, and even to redeem one of his parents. An act of compassion that proves that love is actually stronger than darkness. A man that will try his best to build and create something of his own, only to have it all taken away from him to do his own fear and arrogance. A man that could easily be called as one of the most iconic and most famous heroes in cinematic history. Now, thank you all for tuning this new episode in today's analysis. I hope you all guys enjoyed. Please don't forget to give a like and subscribe, everyone. And may the Force be with you.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.